Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another question and answer time video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. So today question about this histology artifact. So question was how to prevent formerly frequent artifacts in your laboratory. So guys, let's see what is the correct answer is. First of all, we have to know what the formerly pigment is. It is brown-colored granular particles present in formaldehyde preserved tissue sections. It is associated with red blood cells and we can see it in both intra and extracellularity in tissues. The major drawback is that this can be confused with microorganisms or other pathological features in histological sections. Let's see how it is formed. When the tissues are preserved in buffered formalin for long duration, the pH will decrease due to oxidation of formalin to formic acid. Acidity enhances the autolysis and formic acid reacts with the hemoglobin in red blood cells and precipitating acid formaldehyde hematidine or formalin pigment. So, how to prevent this formalin pigment formation? To prevent the occurrence of this artifact, we can use formalin that is well buffered, such as 10% natural buffered formaldehyde. As they have buffering action, it can maintain its pH within 6.8 to 7.2 range. Another way to change the formalin fixative for several times during initial fixations, especially for tissues rich in blood, such as spleen or lymph nodes. This is how we can prevent the acid formalin pigment artifact during histology. But if it occurs mistakenly, how to remove that? There are methods to remove the formalin pigment from tissue section. Before stain the paraffin section, which has formalin pigments, you should deparaffinize it using xylene and then bring it to water. Then dip it in saturated alcoholic picric acid for 1 hour. You can treat it with saturated aqueous lithium carbonate to remove decolorization due to picric acid. But this step is optional. After picric acid treatment, wash the tissue section in water until yellow color is removed from tissues. Now your tissue section is free from formalin pigment. Then proceed with staining. And this formalin can also be removed using alkali such as 1% sodium hydroxide in absolute ethanol. But it is necessary to be careful as this may lead to detachment of section from the slide. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain some knowledge from this video. So every weekend I release this kind of practical medical question and answer type videos. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with my latest videos. Thank you.